The memories still haunt Yüksel Koç. Three of his Turkish political allies were executed at a Kurdish cultural center. French investigators were never able to solve the case, but prosecutors suspect the Turkish secret police were behind the murders. Since then, Koç has feared for his life. At home in northern Germany, he has received a number of death threats in the mail and via text message.
Even if our cover is blown, life is short, so we might as well enjoy it.
Koç suspects that Turkish secret police are behind the threats. He's a member of a group with ties to the Kurdish Workers' Party, the PKK, which is prohibited in Turkey and Germany. Authorities in both countries are suspicious of people who have links to it. But Koç has committed no crime and Germany is providing him police protection. After a witness tipped off the police, German federal prosecutors investigating the death threats issued an arrest warrant for a Turkish suspect. Turkish and German authorities have declined to comment, but the German parliament's domestic policy specialists are horrified by the case.
Yüksel Koç's case is very credible. It's not for nothing that federal prosecutors started investigating spying allegations. And the witness who blew the spy's cover is in a witness protection program. Given that, I find it very credible and also very worrying.
Koç must always be on the lookout. He has to keep on the move. He prefers to spend time in familiar Kurdish circles like this tea room. And the police have given him hints on how he can hide in plain sight.
I don't spend much time in my home city of Bremen at the moment. If I do, I tell the police. I quit my job. The police told me I should constantly change the way I go to work. But there weren't many options. And what use is that when the people persecuting me have my address?
More and more opponents of the government in Turkey are seeking refuge in Germany. Security officials fear that domestic strife in Turkey could spill over into Germany. The Turkish secret police is known to maintain a large network of agents here. Experts say there are more than 6,000 of them.
There are agents who've been instructed by high-ranking officials. And in addition to that, there are many informers who they simply use. So you've got an established surveillance chain, meaning we've got a network of spies so dense it's comparable with the Stasi of former communist East Germany.
The Turkish secret police are also observing mosques in Germany. The association that represents their interests, the DİTİB, has since admitted that in some mosques, there have been reports of agents commissioned by Ankara spying on visitors. So German prosecutors are now investigating DİTİB. Reactions to the news are mixed.
I hope that it didn't happen that way, but I can easily imagine it did. But I hope not.
There is no outside interference, out of the question.
Koç doesn't agree. He says the Turkish government has openly admitted that it's hunting its opponents abroad.
Erdogan has said publicly that either Europe should deal with these people or we will take care of them ourselves. And look at the newspaper headlines. Europe doesn't extradite terrorists, or we've got our eye on the terrorists.
So Turkish opponents of the government must now fear for their lives even when they are out of the country. There hasn't been an assassination attempt in Germany yet, and Yüksel Koç hopes the German authorities will continue to protect him.